So here we are live. Who's out there? Can you hear me? So I'm going to read White Road, a passage from chapter 2, and it's entitled California Dreaming. I'll wait just a second to read it. And first, I'd like to talk a little bit about White Road. So White Road is my new book. It's a memoir, and I'll take a little bit of time to read the back so you can see that, and then we'll talk a little bit more about it. So spiritual pilgrimage has been a part of the human process since the dawn of creation. Traditionally, one travels through their own darkness to get closer to the light of the self. In the land of the ancient Maya, deep in the jungles of Central America, are ancient causeways. These causeways are called Sauk Bays, or white roads. It is rumored that these white roads were metaphorical for the spiritual journey of the Maya. White Road is an inspiring true story of one man's journey of personal transformation. So, this book was written over the past 5 years or so, and I'm really happy to have it done on the full moon on July 9th. And the ninth, or number nine, oftentimes represents completion. So here it is, White Road, completed after 5 years. And I wrote this book for a lot of reasons, but one of them was because I felt like I needed to share all of this. I needed to process, and so here I am. This is a lot, White Road's a lot about relationship. And when you read the book, you'll see that a lot of it's about my relationships, whether love or friendship or business. So I believe that these relationships are what shape us to be who we are and the lessons that we can learn along the way, along the journey, along the White Road. So the Mayans oftentimes, they would ask, like, how's your way? How's your bay, meaning way? So white way. And it's no coincidence that they studied cosmology of the stars, sun, moon, and stars. Just like the Vedic tradition, practitioners of yoga. And so if you look on the cover, you have this white road, AKA Milky Way. And the very center of the Milky Way is the concept of a lot around the Vedic tradition as well. So I'm not going to go too much into it, but I will begin to read this passage from the book. And this is California Dreaming, and it's chapter 2. I had a lucid dream that felt eerily familiar. I was walking to help me think more clearly when I came to a hill that I recognized and felt a strangeness in the air. A gentle breeze blew by that carried the scent of the past. I took a deep breath to calm my nerves and continued walking until the strange feeling turned into comfort and I walked in peace. I made it to the top of the hill and looked around. Seeing maple leaves rustling in a circle, I came upon a lake and noticed that the reflections of landscape in the water were a brilliant purple. After passing through a plowed field and that smelled of the blackest, freshest dirt I had ever smelled, I walked into a structure with people trying to put me at ease. The longer I stayed, the more it looked like a regular house. Time passed, bringing me into a more relaxed state. As I was leaving, I couldn't tell whether it was past, present, or future. But I did know that I was dreaming. I continued on the path and walked that I had walked a few weeks prior. It circled into the lake and turned into a gravel road that turned into a path into the forest. I felt overpowered by the beauty of the trees and came across another clearing. Looking to my left, I noticed a big cliff. I woke up and wrote this poem. Time is not real, not a straight line. Plan ahead until you're dead. Get caught in a race until the end. Think of the past in terms of years, finding the meaning in all of your fears. With nothing expected, you won't have a frown. Life is a gift given to us. Traveling in spirals, there is no beginning and there is no end. There is only now. Not tomorrow or what happens next. When you're living inside the box, time can go by in the blink of an eye. Things can go wrong no matter how hard you try. It's not all shiny and bright. It has to be dark to get to the light. The dream is your creation. Destiny belongs to you. The time can't last forever because it's now or it's never. Can we live while we're clever? So that poem was written in roughly 2009, maybe 7 or 8, something. And it sort of was a great bit of knowledge for me. And throughout White Road, you'll notice I go back and forth into a concept of recognizing the dreams as sort of like guidance for the next step. So I'll have a dream in the book, and it was in real life, and the dream would show me the next step in my personal or spiritual evolution. So in White Road, throughout the book, you have flashbacks into different parts of the dream. And these dreams are guidance for transformation. And so my hope is that when you read White Road, you'll use it as a tool, perhaps, to understand a greater part of yourself for the collective. And also, I hope you laugh, because there's a lot of parts in there that, you know, you wouldn't think would be a spiritual journey. And that's the necessity of polarities that I talk about, and this black, dark space that people don't want to talk about. These things in our lives that are painful and awful and wrong, but the necessity of this pain. And so I really appreciate everyone tuning in, and I hope that you enjoy your day and that you find a benefit from what I'm offering here. White Road. And you can find that on Amazon. Just follow the link in the White Road page. Thank you. Namaste. Adios.